My name is Nadia Lutz, and I am here to talk to you about the balance test, because I'm going to have you do this in a lot of the drills I'll be explaining. So at first, a balance test, depending on how balanced you are, your vestibular sense, would be simply standing here and noticing the sway. Now, if you're an athlete and you have pretty good balance, and obviously this is not going to be challenging for you at all. So the next step would be to close your eyes. And then you would count the number of seconds you had before you would start to sway a little bit. And if someone is really off balance, you may want to have them just have a hand here just in case if someone's really compromised. So that would be level two. And then the next level would be balancing on one foot and just holding. Now, people naturally just pick up the leg, which is good, right? Which is more stable. So if that was good, then you would have them balance on the other foot and you just have them hold, okay? If they're still good, then you would do the same thing. You'd have them come up nice and tall, and then you'd have them close their eyes, and you'd have to count. And when they went off balance, then, okay, that was like 3 seconds, okay? And then finally, one more balance test is heel to toe, standing up tall. Eyes open, eyes closed. So you want to find something that's challenging for the person so that when we're testing before and we're testing after, you'll be able to see the results, okay? So for example, if I have someone in the rhombus right here and they were able to close their eyes and then after 2 minutes, after 2 seconds, they fell off, then when we played a frequency and they came back, then we would know that that was a little bit better for them. So that's the balance test, lots of different options.